Dear viewers, this is an educational video prepared for teaching learning purposes of a course Building Services offered by School of Architecture and Landscape Design at Sri Mata Vaishno Devi University Katra for Bachelor of Architecture program. In this video, we will discuss water distribution systems at city level as well as at individual building level. Water is a precious natural resource and one of the most essential requirement of all living beings. Need of the hour is to understand that quantity of potable water is not sufficient and quality of potable water is also deteriorating day by day. And there are some certain challenges associated in water distribution, and those are finding major source of the supply, because major source of the supply are rivers and the groundwater table. And quality of potable water or the water in rivers as well as in groundwater table is also deteriorating day by day. We have intermittent and erratic supplies in our cities and towns. We don't get water around the clock from the public mains. Water pressure is also very low at consumer ends in several localities. There are inequality in supply to the rich and poor communities. And high rate of water losses from the distribution system is also a major area of concern. Before we discuss water distribution systems at city level, it would be worthwhile to understand basic principles of water supply. And those principles are: water quality should not get deteriorated in the distribution network. System should be capable of supplying water at all the intended places, and sufficient water pressure should be available at all the ends. It should be capable to cater to the firefighting demand of the area as and when may be required, in addition to the domestic and city level water requirements. Minimum shutdown and interruptions to the customers during any repair or maintenance works of any segment of the distribution system. All the water supply pipes should be laid at least 1 meter away horizontally and above the sewer lines at all the locations in the city. It should be properly installed and checked so that there are no leakages or wastage of potable water. In this slide, we will understand how water is obtained from natural resources. Lakes and rivers and the check dams are the major resources from where water is obtained in bulk and sent for distribution at city level. However, before water distribution, water has to be treated appropriately so that it meets the standards of potable water, and this activity is done in water treatment plants. After it is treated appropriately and water quality is checked, then it is sent to the central control stations, and those are known as point of production, and water distribution is controlled from these stations, these points onwards. And after these points, metering of water is also came into picture. Water is carried by the cast iron pipes or the cement pipes, and for bulk consumers, separate main lines are provided to cater to their requirements. However, at city level, several storage reservoirs are constructed, maybe underground or the overhead tanks, and from these central storage or reservoirs, water is distributed to various zones in a city. And there are various methods in which water is further distributed to different localities, and we shall be discussing in coming slides. Water is a natural resource and it has to be obtained from nature only. However, it may contain certain impurities which are not advisable so far as standard of potable water are concerned, and water has to be treated appropriately. Screening, filtering, sedimentation and chemical treatment are certain methods through which water is treated appropriately, and then it has to be transported and distributed at city level. At city level, there are certain distribution reservoirs constructed in different zones, and water is first of all stored in these reservoirs, and from these reservoirs water is further distributed. Based on the pattern of supply and pipes laid at city level, water distribution network is termed in is categorized in four ways: dead end system, gridiron system, ring system, and radial system. Treated water is distributed through a network system of underground pipes, pumps, and other controls and maintenance and safety devices at town level. For efficient distribution system, adequate water pressure is required to be maintained at various points, particularly at the user end. Depending on the level of source from where water is obtained, topography of the area, and other local conditions, the water may be forced into distribution system by following ways. Either it has to be forced or circulated through gravity, or it has to be pumped, or we have to adopt a combined system including the gravity and the pumping system. Gravity system is suitable when source of supply is at sufficient height. It is the most reliable and economical distribution system, and the water head available at the consumer end is sufficient by virtue of the gravity. In pumping system, treated water is directly pumped into the distribution main without storing. This system is also called pumping without storage system. High lift pumps or booster pumps are required at various levels. If power supply fails, then complete stoppage of water supply is observed. So this is the disadvantage of the system. And if we adopt combined gravity and pumping system, then treated water is to be pumped and stored in an elevated distribution reservoir or the overhead tanks. Then supply to the customer is ensured by action of gravity. This is the most economical, efficient, and reliable system. Layout of water distribution system can be categorized in four categories: dead end or tree system, gridiron system, circular or ring system, and radial system. In dead end system, one main line is divided into sublines and then into branches. It is suitable for old towns and cities having no definite pattern of roads, and this is relatively economical in installation. As we can see, this is the water main line, and then this is the sub mains, and these are the branches. And at this end, it becomes a dead end. Determination of discharges and maintenance of pressure is easier in this system due to less number of valves. However, due to many dead ends, stagnation of water occurs in pipes, and which may lead to contamination. In radial system, the entire city area is divided into different zones. The water is pumped into the distribution reservoir, kept in the middle of each zone. The supply pipes are laid radially, ending towards the periphery. However, at the periphery, there is a loop pipe. It gives quick service. Calculation of pipe sizes is also easy, and this is the most suitable system for towns having radial roads. We can see this is the main water supply pipeline, and through this main water supply pipeline, this is the sub line leading to the main central reservoir of a particular zone. And from this main reservoir, there are so many branches are coming out, and they are catering to the water demand of a particular zone. However, this is different in a way from the dead end or tree system, that there is no dead end. At the end of these radial supply lines, they are also connected with a pipe. Gridiron system is suitable for cities with rectangular layouts where the water mains and branches are laid in rectangles. Water is kept in good circulation due to the absence of dead ends in the system. In case of a breakdown in some section, water is available from some other direction at the same point. There are very limited pressure loss in this system, and this system is expensive due to higher length of pipes required, and this may be considered as a disadvantage of gridiron water supply distribution system. In circular or ring system, the water supply main is laid all along the peripheral roads, and water sub main supply lines are branched out from the water supply main lines. This system also follows the gridiron system with the flow pattern almost similar. Water can be supplied to any point from at least two directions, and there are no dead ends, hence chances of stagnant water and contaminations are very rare. We can see that this is the water main supply line, and this is the ring or circular loop maintained at the external periphery of the area catered, and these are the sub water supply lines, and from these water sub mains further branching can be done to the individual units. I presume that you could understand four types of water distribution system. Those are named in view of the geometrical pattern in which the water supply pipelines are laid. To get more clarity, please feel free to replay the video. Now we will discuss water storage methods. In a building, provision is required to be made for storage of water for the following reasons: to provide against interruptions of the supply caused by repairs of water main supply lines, to reduce the maximum rate of demand on the mains during peak hours, to tide over periods of intermittent supply of water in the city, and to maintain storage for the firefighting requirements of the building. The water may be stored in overhead tanks or underground tanks. These are some of the guidelines on how should we store water on site. General guideline for calculation of capacity of storage tanks is indicated. In case only overhead tank is provided, it may be taken as about 33% or 34% to 50% of one day's water requirement of site or the building. In case only underground tank is provided, it may be taken as 50% to 150% of one day's requirement of building or the site. In case combined storage is provided, it may be considered as 66% of underground water storage and about 34% overhead storage of one day's water requirement of building. If the water supply is intermittent and the hours of supply are irregular, it is desirable to have a minimum storage of half a day supply for OHT. In this slide, we will try to understand the basics of underground and overhead water storage in a building. This red color line indicates the water supply from the municipal corporation or the public water supply line. So we may have one direct tap from the fresh water, and we may also get water at our rooftop from the main water supply line for our daily requirements. If we are providing only an underground water tank, then from the public water supply line we may tap one line for fresh water for our use, and remaining water can be collected in the underground water storage tank, from where it can be pumped to upper floors and for other areas of the building. In this system, this is a combination of underground and overhead water storage tank. This is the main water supply line, municipal supply line. So we may have connection to the underground water tank, as well as we may get some connection of fresh water to our kitchen or in the toilets. From the underground water storage tank, water can be pumped to overhead water storage tank, and from where it can be further distributed in the building through gravity. This is an schematic diagram indicating water supply distribution system from municipal water main supply line to a building, and this diagram is taken from the National Building Code of India. We can see that this is the municipal water main supply line, and these are two tapping points where a device named ferrule is installed in order to tap the water for a particular branch. So we can see we have two tapping points here. One tapping point, there is a water meter, and water is discharged to the underground water storage tank, from where it can be further pumped to overhead storage tank, and further supply can be ensured by distributing water through gravity at different floors. And this is the system. If we have adequate water pressure in the municipal water mains, then we don't need to worry. We can get a tapping point, there is a stopcock or the water meter, and then we can have further branching for different floors. And we can, if we envisage the good water pressure even at upper floors, then there is no need of having an underground tank or the water supply tank, particularly if water is supplied for significant duration of the day. Now in this slide we will try to understand how water is distributed in multi-story buildings. There are four basic methods of distribution of water to a multi-story building. One is direct supply from mains, direct pumping system, hydropneumatic system, and overhead tank distribution system. We can see that this is the main supply line. This can be considered as municipal water mains. It can be discharged to the underground water tank, and also it can serve the water requirement at some lower floors. Because water pressure may be limited in the water supply pipeline, and it may not be adequate for water supply at upper floors. So we can ensure water supply from the municipal water mains to specific floors only. So this is the direct supply from main system, in which there is a municipal water mains, and this is the direct supply from municipal water mains. Direct pumping system, if we store water in an underground water tank, and it is distributed at upper floors using the pump, so water pressure is maintained at upper floors also, and water requirement can be catered using this pumping system. We can ensure water pressure at upper floors using hydropneumatic systems. This may be the hydropneumatic systems through which we can ensure adequate pressure in the water supply pipeline even at the upper floors. And we can pump the water directly to the overhead tank kept at the rooftop, and through which this is the distribution system, and this is called as gravity distribution, this dotted line. So this is a distribution from the overhead tank. In previous slide we could get some understanding that how water is distributed in a multi-storied building even at the upper floors using the gravity method or the pumping system or any other method or a combined method. However, it is equally important to understand that how water is distributed at different floors to different zones of toilets and kitchens. If we consider that this is the vertical main, irrespective whether it is the water is coming from the overhead water tank through gravity, or it is being pumped from the underground water tank, we should assume that water will be available in this vertical main pipe. And we have to tap water from this vertical main pipe through these branches, and these branches will carry water, and these shall be connecting to the respective fixtures, maybe the bathtub, maybe the WC, maybe the wash basin. And that is how we distribute water from the vertical main for a particular floor to different zones of a building at the same floor, maybe the different toilets and the kitchen. I presume that you could understand the concept of water distribution from the stage of obtaining water from nature, water treatment stage, its transportation and storage in large reservoirs at city level, and further distribution to various zones of a town and to the toilet or kitchen of an individual building. For more clarity, please feel free to watch the video again. Thank you.